So Gly just got back from crawling down in the hole over here. To go ahead and explain it, Gly.
And this
This is just too dynamite.
Oh,
he
boy.
Is beside himself.
Absolutely, absolutely beside myself. Nobody has been in this mine since 1943, okay? And I just went down over the hill. I knew from looking at all the maps and studying this area, studying the mine, looking at its layout, etc., that there was a good possibility that there was a back entrance into this behemoth of a mine. So I went down over the hill, and lo and behold, I turned the corner, climbed up the waste rock pile, and the angels did sing.
Nice.
I found the back entrance into this thing.
We came out here to recon today to hopefully find it, and you know, if we didn't, then we were gonna have to try to find something else as a plan B, and I had other areas to go check out. But this is the holy grail. This is gonna be a nice one.
Oh my gosh, this thing is so big. I mean, we could be out here exploring for 2, maybe 3 days.
Wow.
But we've jumped the first hurdle, guys. We can get into it. That's the biggest thing. And and to know that we're getting into something that no one has seen in all of these years. It's pristine. In other words, you know what I mean?
I do.
When they blasted the main portal, anything and everything that was in that mine is in there in situ to this very day, and we're going to be the first people to shine a camera on it.
That's pretty nice.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Ah, that's so cool. Wonder why I do this. It's this feeling right here, right now. It's kind of probably that feeling that Indiana Jones got right before he walked into the Temple of Doom. You know, it's right here, it's right now that you know, you don't know what's coming. That adventure of tomorrow, what tomorrow is going to bring, the discoveries and everything else. That's what makes this so much fun for me. I can hardly contain my excitement.
That's not normal, you know.
Well, I like a nice big juicy mine, you know. You know, just like everybody likes a nice big juicy raspberry, I like a nice big juicy mine, and this one's gonna be. Oh, it has, well, there's just so much to it.
I've never heard anybody use a big juicy raspberry like it's an everyday term or something like that. I've never heard that.
Well, hey everybody, welcome back. Well, before I drop my butt down this crazy hole right here, I just wanted to say thank you all for helping me get to over 100,000 subscribers. I really do appreciate it. If we're not at 100,000 by the time you guys see this video, I think I'm gonna be awfully close. But thanks again, I really do appreciate all your support and all of you that have contributed to the channel in helping purchase equipment, etc. So what are we doing today? Well, we're inside of a mine, and I'm trying really hard to stay very clandestine about this location, and here's why. We're in an area that's highly visited by off-road enthusiasts, etc. Tens of thousands of people are through this area each and every year, And the last thing I want anybody knowing is that there is a secret entrance to this mine. That's why on this video, there's no drone footage whatsoever. And the reason I do that, guys, is because as a mine explorer, it is my responsibility to try to keep the public safe, okay? I try to do that. I don't want you guys exploring abandoned mines. Now, I know some of you are qualified out there, but a lot of you aren't. I just don't want you going out trying to do this activity and getting yourselves hurt. And again, that comes back on me. It's my responsibility to try to keep you guys safe. So just sit back and enjoy the show and let me do all of the craziness. So where are we today? We're at a giant tungsten mine, huge tungsten mine. And oftentimes what the miners would do is they would put in a horizontal haulage at it on the other side of mountains or in other areas of the mine to allow airflow, okay? Natural airflow through these big mines. And when I say big mines, this is a big mine. We're talking 15,500 feet of tunnels on 9 levels. That's just absolutely incredible. Problem is that from the 500 level all the way down to the 900 level, it's completely flooded. But from the 500 up here to the 100 that we're trying to get to right now should be nice and dry. Those are the levels I want to try to explore today. This mine produced 118,000 tons of tungsten. It was initially found in 1908. They mined it extensively from about 1937 to 1943. That's when it was at its peak. And then it slowly tapered off through a period of new owners until finally in 1957, they shut it down and that was it. And the reason they shut it down is because of a lack of labor. You had a lot of guys coming back from fighting in World War II. They were coming back to find new jobs. Well, mining tungsten didn't pay all that well, so they went and found other things to do. And ultimately, it was a shortage of labor that shut this mine down. Okay, so I am going to, what we're trying to do now is, this is a short little 40 or 50 foot access tunnel that should get us to right above the 100 level on this mine. And then after that, we should be able to go a little bit deeper and then eventually work our way to the 100, to the 200 and the 300, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, guys, let's explore this old mine. So what I'm doing here, guys,
is stress testing the ladder.
I'm ultimately, I'm stress testing the ladder. Yeah, you're right, Mr. M. That's what I'm doing because, see, Mr. M doesn't have a harness. And I would love for him to go on this adventure with me. Oh, yeah, I need some slack. Give me some slack, Jack. There we go. Well, where's my ladder here? Yeah. A little warbly there, Mr. M, but so far looking good. So what I'm doing here is, yeah, sure, I could probably just use the rappel, you know, the descender. But since I have a ladder here right in front of me, hey, why not use the ladder too? Okay.
I thought that was some good thinking. Ladder goes around the corner there.
Yeah, it does. Got a little bit of an angle here.
That's spooky.
Gets a little narrow, no doubt about it. Yeah, turn my light on here. Let's look. Second here, guys. I need to throw some light on the situation here. Let's see where the heck I'm going. Okay. Because as of right now, I'm kind of blind. I can't. It's a really tight little spot I got here. There we go. I can't even really see what I'm standing on.
You think I'm coming down there?
Well, I don't know yet, Mr. M.
You're out of your mind.
Well, I got to get past this little hole here.
Yeah.
I don't know if I should go. It's a little bit smaller than what I thought it would be. I gotta fix my rope. There we go.
I'm getting claustrophobia just looking at you. I think I'm gonna hurl.
No. What do we have here? I think what I have here is another set of ladders. Oh yeah. Second here, guys. Let me get my okay. I made it to the first level.
You want your camera?
Not yet. I want to see if this thing goes anyplace, okay?
Okay, I'm gonna goof around up here then.
You goof around a bit. Okay, I'm offline.
Okay, but you're recording.
All right, guys. Yeah, for right now, we're just got, let me loosen up my descender here and get offline. Wait a minute. Maybe you guys can see what I'm doing here. There we go. Okay. We are at the first little passage. There. Right now, since I'm standing right here, I'm going to get my rope in such a position or they're not going to snag anything on the way back up. There, I like that. Okay. Now, let's see if indeed we can access this mine. Mm-hmm. Pretty darn crumbly in here. Whew. Wow. Holy cow, look at how that's all come down. So, before I go through, yikes, look at these things. They're just sitting up above my head like giant razors. Good grief. Okay, yep, what I'm gonna have Mr. M lower my rig so you guys can get a better look at this. This is not the kind of situation I wanna be recording with just GoPro footage. So I will be back.
Here it comes.
All right, guys, back again. So here's the ladder we just came down. This is the small manway we just went down, and I'm happy to report that's a really nice ladder. Should be no problem for Mr. M to come on down if this mine turns out to be something bigger. Now what you see before you there, that's my blue bucket that I carry my camera rig in, and that's what Mr. M just lowered my rig down on with a rope and a carabiner. Now, okay, so look at this passage here. No one's been in here for 77 years. And from what I can see, it is just incredibly dangerous. Look at how all of this is slabbing, and these big slabs are coming down like knife edges. See how this one fell? And look above my head here. All of those are shaped like knife blades. I have to carefully get through this without touching anything, because if one of these comes down, it'll be like a guillotine. Look at how that one fell right there and dropped. There's a whole bunch above my head that are wanting to do this exact same thing. Holy cow. Alrighty. Oh, good grief.
Oh my God. He's down there. He's like... He's like, okay, now we're in this passage. You see how this stuff is like slabbing, like this big piece over my head? That's the last thing I heard him saying.
Oh my God. Now you guys want to know what class four is. This is class four. This is what's called high-end class four. I'm just going super slow. I don't want anything to, I want any of this to slab on me, because it's already doing it. All right. Now, according to my little map of this mine, we should work our way this direction and eventually find maybe another set of ladders going down. Let me show you what we have here. You see all that vertical stratification going up? That's why this is all flaking up and falling little by little over 70 years, it's come down. Okay. Now here's a real bad spot. And boy, let's see if I can get over this. Okay, what I have to do, oh, something's beeping on me here. Give me a second, guys. I'm seeing a technical malfunction. Okay. One second. Sorry, guys. There we go. That's better. Okay. So just for a moment, I'm going to set the camera down so I can see if I can carefully climb over this stall. There we go. And see what we have over here, and if this is something that we can get into. All right, so what do we have down there? Quite possibly that goes to another level. I don't know if we're gonna be able to get down there though. Let's keep on looking around here. Let's keep on looking around here. Yeah, that's all breaking up and collapsing. out in front of me. It does keep going that way. Oh boy. I got stuff falling on me. Coming down from above. Just the sound of my voice is letting tiny little pieces fall. What in the world is that? Yeah, it certainly keeps on going, but how am I going to get around this safely and hold a camera at the same time, guys? Let me think here. Well, that stall is definitely holding my weight. What I'm worried about is this rock off to my right flaking down some more while I try to cross this area. Okay, guys, I'm setting my camera here while I work across this. Shoot. Oh boy, don't touch that. There, did it. Okay. Okay, above my head. Oh, sorry. Don't mean to cuss, but I just had a small collapse occur right behind me. We got a manway going up to some other kind of a level. I didn't see that on the map. That's interesting. All right, let's keep going. Now, here's the problem. One of the big problems when exploring tungsten mines is there's a lot of sulfides in some of these veins. And if we can get down closer to water level, I don't know if that's going to be possible, but if we can, there's a risk of hydrogen sulfide gas. I do have a meter on me. There's a dead mouse. Okay. Which is not a good sign. I don't like seeing dead mice at floor level, because that's where the hydrogen sulfide gas will be. Is down by your feet. Okay, let's keep going. And that's as far as we're going here. That's totally pinched off by a collapse. I can only imagine how much rock is above my head right here. I'm not getting through that. It's only 16 to 20 inches through there. I would have to do a considerable amount of digging. All right, turn it back around. Now that we've turned around, I can point the camera up into this, what once was, looks like a stope. See that? You see how all that's flaking and coming down in these big sheets? Yeah, I'm a little nervous right now. This is a very dangerous mine. I mean, let's look at that again. That's a little bit better angle here. Okay, good stuff. So we can't keep going that way. That's too bad. But we do have this ladder going up, but that ain't gonna help us out because that's not the direction we need to go. That's just gonna take us up into the stope. So the only way to access the 100 level of this mine is to go down. All right. And I don't see a way, guys. Hold on a second. I gotta set the camera down again. There's no way I can cross this stall. Oh boy. Just gonna kind of do this in reverse order. Yeah. Okay. So looking down there. I just don't see it going anywhere. I can peek around that slab. I'm gonna back up a little bit. Actually, before I do that, let's look over here. Well, gosh darn it. I had such high hopes for getting into this mine, getting into them lower levels. I just don't. Okay, there's a better view. Let's look down there. That's all collapsed. Yeah, the stope collapsed. Shoot. Bugger. All right, another look back that direction. Turning back around here. See this stuff right here? Let me point it out to you. This right here. These are the sulfides, okay? And when that comes in contact with the water, if you get enough of it, that's what's gonna eventually create your hydrogen sulfide gas. All right, now we gotta cross over this stall once again. Oh. See what's, yeah, you're probably saying, Gly, yeah, you were a little bit nervous in that one. Well, here's why. Let me point it out to you. These sheets here, these are all falling down in these big knife-like plates. They're just dangling here. And you can see the one in front of me right there. This one here fell down like a knife blade. Yeah, that's what's making me nervous. I'm don't want one of them coming down on me. All right, get around the corner. We're kind of headed back to our ladder to give Mr. M, unfortunately, the bad news. Okay, back through the, I'm just gonna be real quiet through this section. Trying to be, yikes. Get me away from that thing. There we go. Okay, we're getting better here. All right. All right, back to a semi-safe spot. All right, I'm gonna give Mr. M the news, and I will be right back. We're gonna make a decision on what we're gonna do next. Yeah, this ladder is in such good shape. And see, I can brace my back against the wall here.
Yeah.
I'm not worried about this ladder at all. Don't put both hands on the same rung. Yeah, I can hear about 3,000 of you screaming at me.
It's Groundhog Day.
Yeah. Okay. Well, there we go, guys. Unfortunately.
Turn your headlamp off.
Oh, thank you.
There.
Unfortunately, on this one, Father Time took his toll. And all of these sheets, see right behind me here. Here's what's happening in this mine. Let me show you. All these layers are falling off like that. Okay, and it's doing this off these sides. And as it's doing that over the years, those are all falling down. And what had happened is eventually they just all fell down and they pinched off what used to be the access ladder down to the 100 level. It's completely destroyed from what I can see. Yep. All right. Well, we're not done yet. Short and sweet, but we have another mine to head off to. So let's go see what that one's all about.